Hey guys, it's Michael. I'm going to be showing you a full Charizard guide. I did get a request for a default Charizard guide, but I really hate flare blitz. Just because it's so punishable. So I might throw in a couple tips on flare blitz if you're using default Charizard. But right now I'm going to show you my custom setup I like to use the most, which is simply replacing flare blitz with dragon rush, which is 1-3-1-1 on the standard Evo custom setup. I will also show you some little tricks with the 1-3-1-3 Charizard, which will replace Rock Smash with Rock Hurl. But moving on real quick with just the 1-3-1-1 Charizard. This is going to be kind of relaxed, so I don't really have anything written out. I'm just going to show you some things with Charizard, and there might be some cuts. So, you know, let's get ready for that. All right. So, at low percentages, or if just starting out the game, most people on, like, say, a Battlefield-esque stage where you start up on an elevated platform, most people like to drop down immediately just to, start in a neutral on the bottom. What I usually like to do is just throw out a drop-through platform Dragon Rush, because a lot of people aren't expecting something that quick to come out that fast. And because it's not Dragon or Flare Blitz, if they block it, you won't get as punished, you know, probably not as hard, because Dragon Rush is a little bit more safe on shield. It actually eats through shields. Well, it doesn't, like, eat a shield. It goes through shields, I should say. Just simply passing through the opponent who's blocking. It's still very punishable if opponents know how to punish. Simply just block it and then run and follow the Charizard who's using Dragon Rush, because there's still a lot of recovery frames on Dragon Rush. But it's not nearly as much as a whiffed flare blitz, so I would say it's definitely much more safe. So if just being in the neutral, I like throwing out short hop nairs, which is just standard A in the air. If you don't do any fast falling, you actually get instant recovery from it, so you can just go straight into like jabs. So in the neutral, if I'm just kind of sort of trying to approach an opponent, I'll throw out a lot of nairs because it's a decent move and you can throw out jabs straight out of it. So if, say, an opponent is blocking and you go up, throw out a nair, then immediately throw out jabs. A lot of the times they expect you to have a slower nair recovery, so they'll run right into your jabs. Nair is actually can be unsafe on block if you hit them early in your animation. So if you hit them like up here in your animation and they block it, they will be able to punish you. So a lot of the times if I notice they're trying to punish me off of that, I'll throw out a nair and immediately like back off midair. So I'll be charging them, throw it out, and then back up midair to so even if they do block my early part of the nair, I can back off and run away if I know that's going to happen. Otherwise, like I said, you do recover really fast off a nair. So, just doing a short hop nair. So just throw out jabs if you think they're going to be running in. So if they're like, I got to reset Mario down here. Whoop. So if you're about this distance from them and you just throw out a nair and then immediately you think they're going to run in to try to grab you, just throw out jabs. Other things I like to do in the neutral. Against opponents who have decent projectiles, who like to projectile against you and then like run in, I'll like perfect shield a projectile from like Mario throwing a fireball and then throw out my side tilt, because it, as you can see, it throws out a lot of range to it and it can actually punish pretty well. It can actually launch opponents pretty far at higher percentages, as you saw there. And if you watch my tilt guide, it can actually kill on the sweet spot. At mid 100%. Not anything too low, but yeah, at like 130-ish, sweet spotted side tilt will kill. If you do hit opponents on the sour spot of your nair, which is pretty much the on your non-fiery part of your tail, so like if you just hit them on the early portion of it, like that, you can occasionally, at certain percentages, still combo off of that. I'm going to see if I can get some set up. No, skip that. I don't use down tilt like at all, except for edge guarding like that. So other people might say down tilt is good. It is quicker than side tilt, like I showed in my tutorial. But I just like side tilt so much more for spacing, because it, as you can see, there's much more of a horizontal distance, or you know, vertical slash horizontal distance, at least on the upper vertical portion of it, than down tilt, even though down tilt is slightly faster. And side tilt can be a kill move. Well, you know, down tilt really is just a horizontally launching move. Up tilt, didn't really, I mean, my tutorial video for tilts was pretty short, so I'll give you a little bit more in-depth look into up tilt. Up tilt is more of a punishing move when opponents are coming down from the air and you're anticipating their landing area, especially for like characters like Luigi, who has like NATO to try to punish you for punishing their recovery from up top. There is invulnerability on the wings, so you can just throw that out. If like Luigi's trying to land with a NATO right on top of you, just throw out an up tilt. And I do have my C stick set to up tilt, so I can either do that, or I don't have tap jump on my actual analog stick, so I can just hold that up and just keep pressing A to throw that out. At low percentages, I would not use this as like a horizontal attack, because even if you're close to opponents, it does not hit often. See, I'm like right on top of Mario, it's not hitting him at all. So you obviously have to use this as a move to punish recovering opponents from above, even if you're edge guarding. Whoops. If you're edge guarding, they're like right on top of you right here. Just throw out an up tilt, and it can even kill at higher percentages. At lower percentages, it can combo into itself. Usually I don't hit people at 0% with up tilt. It'll be more like, you know, around 24, like it's showing here. So I'll get like 2 up tilts into an up air like that. Usually people can air dodge pretty easily out of the up air, so unless I'm really quick about it, I'll just get the 2 up tilts, and then I'll try to, you know, set myself up for let me see, around 20% what that does. It's so hard to get a computer set up for an up tilt, so I'll like set up for here, I'll show it here. Boop, boop. I'll just set up for where they're landing and try to throw out like an up smash or something to punish their landing. Up smash, again, the wings do have invulnerability to them. So if an opponent's coming down like Luigi again, because I played David and he plays Luigi, coming down with a NATO or something, you can just throw that out too. It's a little bit slower than up tilt. That's why I like throwing out up tilt a little bit more than up smash, especially through platform. So if an opponent's above you, I can just quickly throw out an up tilt and punish opponents who are just, you know, an opponent who like lands here in recovery and tumble and needs to like roll to one of this and needs to roll to recover. I'll just sit under where I expect them to come. Even though a smash, you can dash and up smash a little bit more easily than you can dash, stop, and then up tilt, because you need to be stopped to do your up tilt. I'll still like try to anticipate where they're coming, and up tilt does cover a decent range on that platform. You know, it covers pretty much half that platform, so I'll just throw out up tilts. And so like a Yoshi who's recovering, or a Bowser who has a down B that would like demolish you if they like landed right on top of you, with a platform you can, you know, try to, you know, bait them into recovering with a down B on the platform and just throwing up an up tilt and killing them or something. Up air is pretty decent. It's a good kill option if opponents aren't expecting Charizards to, you know, come up and like throw an up air to kill them. It can kill at a pretty decent, you know, pretty decent point. I'd say around the low hundreds with rage or something. I don't know percentages too well, guys, you know, to be honest. I just kind of throw out moves and hope for the best most of the time. I was trying to spike there, but I suck at spiking. So up air is good, except for it's easily air dodged, and if you get stuck in the animation, you can actually get punished for doing an up air. So I usually reserve up airs for like really hard reads that, or like really good reads that I know I'm gonna hit the up air. Like I go up there, bait the air dodge, and then throw up my up air, or I just use that on like Battlefield to, you know, throw it on these upper platforms here, because, you know, it'll hit opponents who are trying to recover on the top platform pretty easily. And even if they do block it, you can usually quick drop down fast enough and into recovery frames to get out of there if you need to. Forward air is a great move. You know, it's a good edge guarding move when opponents are edge guarding low. So if you like throw out your flamethrower and they're falling down low, you can just like, you know, quick drop down there into a forward air. Or even if they anticipate you flamethrowing on the edge here and they actually go low, and they throw out like a laggy move. Like occasionally my brother will try to throw out fireballs with Luigi to stop me from like going down to edgeguard him. If he like throws a fireball from like in this area, I'll just, you know, jump off real quick, do a forward air because he'll still be in the recovery animation. And a forward air at, you know, decently high percentages will, you know, kill them or even send them horizontally far enough where they can't even recover on stage anymore. Otherwise, I reserve forward air for comboing off a down throw, because down throw does not throw people far anymore. That's reserved for up throw. So you can just see they don't really launch that far, which means you can combo off of it. In my down throw and up throw video, I said you can actually do fly off a down throw like this, and it can connect. At low percentages, yes, but, you know, practicing more with it, I tend to use forward air off of low percentage down throws, so like that. It does, you know, pretty much just as much damage, if not a percentage more, I think. I think that 17, where if I did up, or if I did fly out of it, it would only do 16. So, on most opponents, if you grab them at 0%, all you have to do is like a short hop forward air. Unless they DI away from you, then you might need to do a full hop forward air. Otherwise, anything pretty much above that, you do have to do full hop forward airs to connect the forward air. Opponents can air dodge or DI away from it. You can anticipate that by just being quick about it, or just kind of delaying it a little bit, see if they air dodge, and then throwing it out. You can also, some people say that you can just nair off of this, and that can be decent too. You can, like you just saw there, I hit him into that platform and just continued the combo. So you can do that. It might connect a little bit more often than forward air, but it does not do as much damage, I don't think. Let me reset and just check the percentage on that. Down throw. Yeah, it does only about 13. So it might be a little bit more reliable as far as hitting it into for more combos, but it does not hit the sweet spot. In more cases than not, it'll hit the sour spot, so it does less damage. Mid percentages, still, I just do full hop fairs. I pretty much just combo with fair off a down throw for, in most cases, because I've noticed that once people catch on to the down throw fly, they can just DI out of it pretty easily. So I'll like anticipate how they're going. If I see that they DI away a lot, I'll just fill forward air. But if I notice that they don't really do anything, you can still hit the down throw into fly. And like I said, around in my up throw and down throw video that I posted a couple weeks ago, at like 90%, I think, you can actually do down throw into a kill setup fly. So let me just set that up real quick. Let's just do 94. But you have to, as soon as you do your down throw into fly, you have to jam your analog stick in the direction they are going, which is usually away from you. So you do fly and then immediately press the, in that case, left on your analog stick. In this case, it'll be right. So down throw into up special and immediately just press and hold right so you can direct your fly into them. But like I said, just do that on cases where you know they're not really DIing away from you at all and you can connect it, because it's actually pretty hard to connect if they are DIing away from you, and you can get punished pretty hard because you have to go into recovery animation. Up throw, because I use Dragon Rush at like 0% for anywhere from like 0 to like maybe 5 or 10%. You can do the up throw into Dragon Rush. Let's try 8%. If you like delay it for a second too, right after the up throw, most opponents really won't be expecting it, and you can just throw it out. And, you know, a lot of people don't know about it because nobody plays against Charizard. So you can just do up throw, delay a little bit, and then use Dragon Rush to push them off stage. And boom, even more punish. So you can even follow it off of that, follow up off that Dragon Rush. I mean, most of the time when you do that kind of a combo, you're off stage with them, So it's more of my priority just to recover back on stage than to, you know, follow up. But if they're not paying attention, you can still follow up off of it. Again, at mid percentages, you can still do up throw into Dragon Rush. You just have to do a jump into it first, like I did there. Again, since most people don't play against Charizard, a lot of people don't expect it. A lot of people are expecting like two jumps into like a forward air or something. So a lot of times I just throw out Dragon Rush. Sorry. A lot of the times I just throw out Dragon Rush and they're not expecting it after a jump. You know, that was 60%, so I would suggest not throwing it out after 60. After that, just go back into your down throw into like, up air or fair. I forgot to mention about down throw too. You can also mix up your game a little bit. If like they're air dodging a lot out of your follow up fairs like that, you can actually just, you know, do a chase down into it like an up air. Or if you're just anticipating them, this is not a good spot to show you. But let me get Mario back down to a good spot. Okay, he's down there now. All right. So you can either do, like I said, down throw into an up air, a chase down up air, which can connect. But then again, they can air dodge again. So a lot of these aren't true combos. They're just, you know, you reading your opponent, or a down throw into a chase down up smash, or, you know, it's pretty much either that or up air, or even follow up, chase down nair if you want. You know, any of those options kind of work. Like I said, they can still air dodge out of it, or DI away, or attack again the follow up. But those are just some options. Okay, so back air. Back air I rarely use, except for like really good reads. Again, like I said, with up air, it needs to be a good read. It's a really good kill option at low percentage. So, well, not low percent, but like 80%. So really early kill, especially if you have rage. But I reserve it either for like opponents who have bad up Bs and they're trying to recover low. Not so much Mario, because he has a decent up B that recovers quick. But like a Fox, where they have to sit there charging, you know, starting up their up B animation and then going. I'll wait for them up here, and then I'll just, as soon as I know they're starting their animation and I time it correctly, you can just drop off, throw out a back air back here, and I actually didn't die. And you can just hit them straight into the bottom of the stage. Unless they tech, that will kill them. At like, you know, high-ish percentage, around like 80 or something, that will kill them. Otherwise, the only other time I really use it is if they're recovering really high up stage, like up here. And I'm just sitting down here on stage, and suddenly I just jump up and throw back air. I'm anticipating their trajectory of where they're landing. I do hit it on occasion. Otherwise, most of the time, I just really don't use it because it has a ton of recovery. As you can see right there, I'm just going to be mashing the stick back and forth like this as soon as I throw it out from a short hop. Yep, and it took that long to recover. So it has a lot of landing lag. Even in the air, I mean, if you do a full hop, you don't really have as much recovery. Unless you're like coming down and throwing it out. But if you like do a full hop straight into it, you don't really have recovery landing lag, which is decent. But still, there's a lot of lag at the end of it regardless. So I don't really use it that often. Down air, obviously, is the spike move. I do use it on occasion for edge guarding. If like I'm sitting here and they're edge guarding low, or if they're recovering low, and I notice that they just kind of hesitate on the edge right here as soon as they grab it because they have those few frames of recovery. Kind of like Captain Falcon, if Charizard does a short hop down air like that, you can actually spike them right off the stage. So if, like I said, again, if they're recovering and they grab onto ledge and they're just sitting there for a second because they think you're going to do a move, and you know that their recovery or their invulnerability frames are about to finish, just do a short hop like down air like that and you can actually just spike them down. Otherwise, like I've showed in other basic edge guarding videos, if you do like flamethrower, if you have the full flamethrower going and you have an opponent out there on the edge, if you hit them with like the tip of your flamethrower and then immediately go into like a down air, you can actually spike them. So a lot of the times with like Luigi, who's recovering horizontally, I'll throw out my flamethrower, hit them with the edge of it, and then they'll get pushed down so that you can just throw a down air and spike them. Otherwise, you can do some really hard reads where, like, Luigi, again, sorry, I use Luigi for all my examples, but that's David playing him, so I know how to edge guard against him. Luigi, who uses side B, has a decent amount of recovery frame. So as long as he doesn't randomly get a misfire and he's recovering with like a side B from like over here, you can do like a short jump or a short hop into like a down air right there. If you just anticipate where he's going to be at the finish ending animation of his side B, and you can just jump out and do a down air and spike. Same with like characters like Captain Falcon, who have a crappy recovery, and or Ganondorf, who recover for, like, horizontally with their up B. Just jump out there where you think where their ending frames of their up B are going to be, depending if it's a custom or not, and just throw out a down air, and you can just spike them down. I do that against David's Ganondorf, too. Not a ton, because it's actually hard to edge guard against his custom Ganon, because he uses the custom up B, which, you know, has a lot of active frames at the end. So more times than not, I'll do a jump out and then do like a back air to try to, you know, kill him or whatever. Oh, down smash is a decent edge guarding tool as well. It hits actually a decent portion of the stage. So if they're like recovering below you and they're trying to double snap where they don't have their invulnerability frames if they grab on again, a lot of times I just use down smash. Otherwise, you can use side smash and direct it down, and you might be able to hit them if it's a character who has like their head hanging way above the stage like Charizard does. If it's an opponent who like hangs low like Ganondorf, who just has the fingertips showing, I throw out down smash. Otherwise, flamethrower is, you know, an edge guarding, like my bread and butter when it comes to edge guarding. I just throw it out. And as long as it's a full flamethrower and it's not like a wimpy one like this, it usually does the trick. If an opponent is recovering from the edge and you expect them to either jump to just normal recovery or even attack recovery, who has a kind of crappy attack recovery from the edge, I like to just throw out nairs, because this covers a lot of space and a lot of options. If you just throw out nair by the edge on a recovering opponent who's, say, jumping like this, you'll hit them and you'll just hit them back off stage. So, you know, Charizard isn't one of those characters who likes to dig really deep, like way out here for their kills, because he just can't recover from it because his recovery is garbage. Well, I want to say it's garbage, but his vertical recovery is kind of garbage. His horizontal one, either with Flare Blitz or with Dragon Rush, is pretty good. But his, like, once, like, as far as edge guarding, he really can't edge guard too far out, because he needs to get back up here, because he's just going to die otherwise. Other potential edge guardings are, like, like Mario throwing out a nair. Charizard can just drop off and throw out a nair like that and still be able to get up here. If you see an opponent recovering like that, you can just nair off stage. I've also been trying to work on finding an application for B reversal rock smash off stage. So if you see, like, again, a Fox or somebody who has a crappy recovery and they're recovering low right below you, just throw out a rock smash B reversal, and that covers a lot of space. And as long as you time it right and you don't like quick fall out of it, you should be able to recover. The only problem is, since it has so much startup to it, It only really hits opponents who are, like, really far down and trying to recover vertically. Since I just told you about it, B reversal is, for Rock Smash, is, like, your best friend, because it mixes up your recovery options, especially if you're recovering up high and opponents, like, trying to up smash you or something, like Mario would be. You can, like, do a B reversal, like, try to fall behind him where you think... If Mario's right there and he's trying to up smash you, you can fall behind him and he'd be like, oh, easy up smash. Wrong, because you can just throw out a B reversal, take the hit from the up smash, and just punish them. And if they're at, like, you know, I think I might have to do some testing, but, you know, like 130 or above, you could even kill them with it. If you hit them with the sweet spot of it, which is like your head hitting the rock. All right, so let's try this. Let's reset in the middle. Boom. Yep, it'll kill Mario. So, and that was even the sweet spot of it. That was like him hitting the rock portion. If he hits your head, you send him flying like that, and you will kill them. So B reversal, really good. Rock smash in general is a good move for hard reads, though. Only for really hard reads. If the opponent knows you're going to throw it out, it has a lot of recovery, a lot of startup, so they can, even fast opponents can grab you out of the startup frames. So if you're like still not hitting the rock yet, opponents can just grab you out of it. And if they're on top of you and they hit your body before you hit the rock, if they hit your body enough, they'll just poke through your armor and, you know, and then you get punished. So use it sparingly. Don't just spam Rock Smash. Use it for B reversals on recovery, B reversals off stage. You know, I just love B reversals in general. You know, just throwing it out like that. Like I said, but like I showed you in my tutorial for B reversals, it takes a lot of practice. Aerial B reversals are a lot easier to do than B reversals on the ground. A lot of times I just end up throwing Dragon Rush out by mistake. But that's also another reason why I love Dragon Rush over Flare Blitz. Because if I accidentally throw out a Dragon Rush, even on the edge of the stage here, I can recover. Whoop! That might not be a recoverable one. Sorry. No, because I fell off the stage first. So let's rewind real quick and show you. If you're on the edge of the stage right here and you're not actually off the stage, you can still recover. So just two quick flaps and then recover back and you're there. For Flare Blitz, you would be dead at this point. If you threw out Flare Blitz from the here, you'd die. You wouldn't be able to recover. But with Dragon Rush, you can. And you don't take the self-inflicting damage that Dragon Rush or Flare Blitz that gives you, that like 9% or whatever. And it's just safer. So honestly, I love Dragon Rush compared to, you know, Flare Blitz. Couple tips if you use Flare Blitz. Use it for like really hard reads. You know, Charizard is a hard read kind of character, especially a default one because you have Flare Blitz. So if opponent is using projectiles that are really laggy and has a lot of end lag to it, you can eat through the projectiles with Flare Blitz and just, you know, hit them. And, you know, at like 130, that would easily kill them. If I have to play in a tournament that's just default characters, I pretty much just don't use it. He has a bunch of other options. Charizard does that you can use. What else? What other moves? His side smash, it's so laggy at the end of it that I pretty much don't use it that often. I only use it to like outspace somebody because it is actually really long, a long move, like horizontally. So like if I'm playing a Link who's using jabs, his Link's jabs will, you know, pretty much be the same length as your tilt. So if he's jabbing me at like the perfect jab range, I'll just charge up my side smash and punish him because, you know, Link's will have ending lag on, you know, their jabs or even their smash attacks. If he uses a smash attack against me and he's not using the second part of it, you know, Link has two parts of his side smash, one and then two if he presses A again, I'll just use side smash to punish him. Otherwise, it's a really hard kind of read kind of move. If you see an opponent recovering low and they don't grab onto the edge again like that and they're just flying up here in like, you know, La La Land and they have to recover, use side smash. Use side smash to outspace, like I said, because it's a decent horizontal move. Otherwise, use it sparingly. I use tilt way more often to space than side smash because, you know, side smash because it has so many ending lags and so much ending lag to it. I don't use it too often, except for like really hard reads. What else? Oh, Rock Hurl, the 1-3-1-3 setup for Charizard. Rock Hurl comes out faster, or actually has instant armor on frame 1, I hear. Or at least that's what I've been told from the Charizard forums. It has frame 1 armor on it. So instead of, if you're going against an opponent who's juggle heavy, like Zero Suit Sam is, or, you know, Diddy, or Sheik, any of the top tiers, I'll switch to a 1-3-1-3 Charizard. So if they're juggling me and they're, you know, getting me up towards the top of the stage, I just throw out Rock Hurl instead of Rock Smash. And that'll either eat up the armor frames to get me out of that combo and even possibly punish them for it. But a lot of the times you'll have to do like a B reversal in the middle of the combo, because if you just use a Rock Hurl in the middle of the combo, they'll end up just eating through your armor and going past you. And not getting hit by your Rock Hurl. So if you do a B reversal in the middle of a combo, one of their combos, and eat through their combo to break out of it, you can still punish them with their Rock Hurl. It's a little bit hard to show in training, but trust me, in application, it can work. Oh, Charizard on the edge. If you're on the edge like this, two of the things I like to do. If you use Flare Blitz, you could probably do this, but I like to do a drop down into Dragon Rush like that. So again, drop down into jump into a Dragon Rush, or even, I guess, Flare Blitz, this would work too. Or my other option, if they're like really hanging on the edge right here where I am with Charizard and like trying to really hardcore edge guard you with, you know, something, you can do a short drop into a rock smash. And I've actually won games doing that where an opponent is like really trying to like down smash me as a Yoshi or something, because Yoshi has a pretty decent covering down smash, or a Pikachu who does that, who's like just trying to down smash on the edge here, you know, like right here. I'll grab on with my invulnerability frames, and I'll drop down, eat some of that attack with my Rock Smash armor, and then just punish them hard. And again, if they're in the high percentages, especially if Charizard has Rage, that will kill them. I've won a couple tournament matches doing that. Just because nobody expects, you know, Charizard to have that much armor on Rock Smash, and boom. Or, like again, I said, short drop into a Dragon Rush like that. Ledge trumping with Charizard is okay. He doesn't really have a lot. I mean, you can do a right after your ledge trump. You can do like sorry, I'm really bad at ledge trumping because I never do it with Charizard. You can just do like a back air like that, a drop down into a back air, or a jump off into a forward air like that. Both options could work, but I don't use it so much because back air still has a decent amount of startup. Even though it does cover a lot of space, it does have a lot of startup. Otherwise, I would just do a forward air, jump off a ledge with a forward air like that. But you do have to be kind of careful, because if you don't ledge trump properly, you can fall like way down here, and then you have to recover. Oh, I forgot. I almost forgot. Another kill setup. This isn't a true combo. Again, like none of Charizard's combos are true. But you can do, if you see an opponent end with a laggy move right on top of you and you're shielding or something, and you have the chance to jab, at higher percentage, you can do two jabs into fly, and it will kill them. Let's reset them in like more of a neutral area. So like I said, if they're like jabbing you, and they jab you on like this platform, and you're right in front of them, and they have a laggy ending jab, just do two jabs, and then go straight into fly. Again, opponents can jump out of it and stuff, but since nobody plays against Charizard, you can get this once or twice during a set. Just jab, jab, into fly. Or you can even do one jab. It's a little bit more consistent with two jabs, because the first jab pushes opponents back, and the second jab actually brings them back in and like launches them right on top of you, so you can throw out your fly. I would suggest only doing this, though, if like you're right on top of them and they're right on top of you. Because if you do it spaced out like this, where there's a little bit of a gap, it could miss. And it misses more often than not, because opponents will be holding back on you. So, again, if they're like doing a laggy move and they land right on top of you, just do jab jab at higher percentages and fly. Even that missed. So, honestly, it can be, you know, it's hit or miss, honestly. I mean, it's a good kill setup. Because a lot of people don't see it coming, but you can miss it. Other kill setups. I already did down throw. Oh, I forgot just to mention, obviously, up throw is now kill throw. So, like, your best stages to play on are, like, Battlefield. Duck Hunt, if you play towards the trees are really high. You know those ledges are really high there. So Duck Hunt by the trees are really good for Charizard. For his up throw kill. What other stages? I guess Dreamland is decent. Town and City, because apparently that has a low ceiling. And with the platforms on stage, you could get early kills. But, you know, at 130, this would easily kill Mario on the top platform. Yeah, easy kill. Reset over here, even at 130 on a mid-platform. Easy kill. And this is training mode again, so remember, there's no rage attached to Charizard right now. I don't believe. That's what I've been told. I could be wrong, so don't quote me on that. So this is just, you know, Mario at 130 getting hit by up throw. And because up throw goes up like Kirby's up throw, you will automatically go to the platform you're right below. So if I'm right here doing my up throw, it will throw Mario right up to this platform. And that's where he'll get launched from. So like I said, Battlefield's great because there's three platforms. Even the mid platforms you can get decently early kills with on up throw. Duck Hunt because of those, or Town and City because of those platforms can be so high. You can get kills with your rage and them being at like 80%, get a kill at that early. You know, it's happened. I've gotten kills that early with up throw. So up throw, probably your best kill option if you can get the grab. Charizard's grab range is decent. It's not so reliable because sometimes it seems like it grabs from really far and sometimes it doesn't. But it has a... see, like, that didn't hit. But, like, dashing grab is pretty good. You can do a jab and grab, which is just jab and then grabbing. But, you know, you have to, like, wait a decent second to actually throw it out. That's decent, though. But, like I said, up throw is his best kill option. What else? I think that's pretty much it. So if you guys think I forgot something to talk about, just leave it in the comments. Otherwise, I hope you enjoyed this video. I talked about Flare Blitz a little bit, which I hate it. But, you know, if it's a default setting in a tournament, you have to use it. I just don't use it too often, except for like a heavy punish on a projectile-heavy character who has a lot of landing and ending lag to the projectile throwing, or just a really hard read in general. Because it does have super armor on it. One more thing about Dragon Rush. You can do short hop Dragon Rush, and it eats through some projectiles, like Luigi's Fireballs. You can do a short hop, and as long as you hit it not on the ground, because if you do a Dragon Rush on the ground and hit a Luigi's Fireball or something, like a medium-sized projectile like that, you'll just bounce off of it. But if you do in air Dragon Rush, you can actually eat through some projectiles. So, like, I usually do, like, if I want to approach an opponent on the bottom of the stage here, I'll do, like, a short hop. Who's throwing a lot of projectiles, mind you. Just short hop into Dragon Rush, and I can usually punish them. But, yeah, just, like, comment, subscribe, whatever. If you have any other ideas for Charizard-based videos, let me know. And, boom, Spike! Peace out, guys.